as you can see, I did move, but no worries, I'm still gonna deliver that heat.
So if you follow me on Instagram or Twitter, I'm sure you noticed that I've watched the Birds of Prey movie. And I have to say, it was amazing. Please give me a second while I celebrate.
This is a new year, y'all.
And let me tell you, I left that theater on cloud nine. I just thought that there was no way that any of these haters could say anything bad about the movie. Margot Robbie isn't problematic. The cast was super diverse. The fight scenes were A1. The costume design was unmatched. And I didn't even know that I needed to watch Harley Quinn beat up people with glitter bombs until I saw this movie. What else do you want? Side note, I love that this was a breakup story that didn't include the Joker, because I'm tired of watching women get over men and then you see that man all the time. My friends, when I say the haters are creative, I truly underestimated them. You guys, Birds of Prey is one of the best movies that DC has dropped in years. And that's not included in Joker, which, let's face it, is not a DC movie. I enjoyed it so much that I would actually say that I liked it better than John Wick. Yeah, I said it. Watching Keanu Reeves fight some nameless hitman over a pissing contest that resulted in the death of a puppy just doesn't resonate with me the way that Birds of Prey did. Look, that's just my opinion, and there's no amount of actuallys that you can drop in my comments that will change my mind. Now, to get you off my back, I will discuss some flaws that I noticed. The biggest thing that I noticed is that Cassidy Kane is very different. She doesn't know how to fight yet, and she talks a lot. I found it pretty jarring, but I had to remember that this is an adaptation and not quite the Cassidy Kane that I've read about before. But if Marvel can make the Skrulls the good guys, why not have a talkative mute? One thing that I wish they made clear in the marketing is that Harley Quinn is not and does not become a member of the Birds of Prey. She simply gets help from them after they all have similar interests. And I feel like that's why some people who are like really true to form did not watch it. And really, they missed out. But I gotta say, the worst part of this movie were the men, specifically Chris Messina. He had this weird, I guess, New York, Brooklyn gangsta, I don't know, accent going on, and it was clear that he's just some classically trained actor trying to be a thug, and I hated it. I just could not focus whenever he was on screen, and I couldn't take him seriously, which is crazy. He takes people's face off, but it still didn't take away from the overall movie. Look, I got a lot of things to say about this movie, so stay tuned for the rest of the week as you see some interviews with women and men that I've been having over this movie and why it's potentially not doing well. But until next time, have a fantastic week, my friends.